literally promised you there was gonna be a deer dead.
I wouldn't doubt that. We were like, what, one a day?
Well, we went like 2 days with nothing, and then it was like, boom, morning, afternoon, morning.
Yeah, we had 2 days of nothing but rain and shit.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be windy as fuck tomorrow, I think.
Really? Well, let's fucking do this shit.
Come on, boys.
Country border approaching.
How do I know if it's broken and too broke to fix? I can't taste your lips like I used to. See, I fell in love with the heartbreaks, not what you did, you weren't me.
What do you rate those glizzies? Soft six?
Fucking 10. Have you ever had a Sonoran dog?
No.
That's a Sonoran dog.
Grande.
Well, at least we got a shed.
Yeah. Wow. Dude, this is wild.
Yeah. As soon as this lets up, man, we gotta get on the mountain.
I don't think so. I mean, it's a half inch or probably quarter inch in the last 30 minutes.
It's supposed to go till noon?
Yeah.
That's 4 fucking hours of snow. This could get fucking epic.
It could get fucking wild. Yeah, I would think that this is gonna make me at least start cruising.
What's this bug? Right here. 107.
Oh, I think that's the one that was like 98.
Alright. I think I got the head. You ready?
Yep. Got that one.
Nice.
Oh, there's the other one.
Let me borrow your earplug real quick. Yeah.
Damn. That was fucking cool. Smoked him, dude.
Salud!
Salud!
Cheers. It's a video. Thanks, boys.
Yeah, hey, congrats.
Nice job. I think we realize it's not the gun's fault.
Wasn't he sitting up top?
See more from right here. Just that hill right here. That middle hill will block your view.
Oh, okay.
What a deer.
Yeah, he's a big deer.
Yeah, I got his little pass.
It's right in a tree. All you can see is his legs.
You see that straight tree that was the perfect apple tree? Where's it up from there?
It's apple tree, right above it, to the left.
Okay, so it's on the, it, there's like those
see
two.
See the one that's like halfway, it's dead halfway
yeah,
up?
Yeah, yeah,
look to the left.
Okay.
All you see is the legs in the tree.
Gotcha.
It's in the tree.
Gotcha, I see where it's at.
Yeah, I remember where the does
yeah, are. I see his ass still, I got him.
Okay.
Dialed at 8.5, or 8.25.
11.
8.5.
That's right where Rudy said he saw it. Dude, I just send it, Taylor. It sure looks like a buck spot.
It looks like he's 105.5.
Yeah, I think he's at least 106.
Got damn good eye guard, man.
Yeah.
They're like 5 inches. Here. That fucking glare is fucking brutal.
See that rock slide?
Yep.
He's gonna come out right there.
Yeah.
He's at the very right edge of that tree.
Okay,
he comes
stepping
right
out
there.
Okay, let us know
485.
When.
485. Okay, whenever you're ready, shoot him.
Go for it.
Alright, you guys ready?
Right in the front shoulder.
Right in front of him to the right. Oh, yeah. You hit him in the face, dude.
Yeah, I think you hit him in the face.
No, I got him.
Where'd he go?
Okay. Down and left from where he was originally.
How
standing
far?
Broadside in the fucking wide open shit.
How far down and left?
Hey, you see where it almost makes this like little horseshoe of grass?
Oh, go straight left into the wide open.
Ready? Yeah, go.
That one's gonna kill him.
Okay, Taylor, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so remember the tree you just shot him at?
He's dead. He's dead.
Oh, yeah. I see him.
He's dead. Hell yeah.
Good work, Poppy.
I'm sorry. I shot so much. Oh, boy.
How come my deer didn't do that?
What a fiasco.
Nice hit.
Oh, man.
The last one pounded.
Thanks, man. Big ol' eyebrows on him.
You're the only person that doesn't have to worry about getting their cape across.
I'm like, left to right's okay!
I know, but he kept saying that in my head.
That sucks, I fucking got him in the face. I put it right on him.
Whose capes are cheap?
Hey Hunter, you got a copy?
Around. Have you guys been able to see him yet?
Yes, from what I've been watching, he is the bigger buck, the bottom one. His ass is facing us right now, Hunter.
There's one big ass yellow spot with hardly any trees in it that's just above the sunlight, that's facing directly at you, like where you park. They're right below that big open spot, just barely into the shade.
Yes, the one that is broadside, will run the hill to you guys, is the bigger buck that I've been watching. He's moving, he just fanned.
Oh! I hope
you
watched yours. I was like, okay. Get it.
Running the gunning, boys.
He said get it, I'm like, okay, boom!
I was like, buried on it. I'm like, oh, this crosshair is not moving at all. And then you shot, and it was like, coming down. I shot right in front of
him. I watched his fucking arm go like this. I was like, oh, he's fucking dead.
Hey, did both of those shots hit?
I think you shot first. Shot. Yeah, I think you got his ass.
Yeah, the first shot smoked him.
Yeah.
Better than shit.
Boys.
Hey, Hunter, who shot first? Garcia did.
I think he's dead laying like that.
Are you sure that he's not dead? Like, is he moving at all?
He laid his head down on the dirt after you guys shot.
Yeah,
him.
He's dead.
You guys hit him.
Got it.
There it goes. How far is it?
580 or something. Like 10 yards from it. He's off the horse.
Oh, he's stone dead, dude. Here, Hunter.
That's a big deer.
He just loaded him up. What a buck.
Is that the cat?
I was like, no way.
Dumped him.
That's so cool.
Bucks on the Burro, dude.
Arm.
Turn it towards you. More. There you go. Fucking A.
Somebody leave a deer by the door?
In a place.
Drinking a beer. Oh, gracias.
No gracias, amigo.
Go there for work and...
flowers grow. I was wishing the world would stop when you said
back in from Sonora, Mexico. Had a pretty good trip. Hunter and Trevor put together with Sonora Outdoors. These guys had a very good ranch locked down for us. Made a quick run down there, a little bit quicker than we expected. Kind of wanted to do a little bit more hunting, but ended up killing three of the four bucks we went after within the first 3 days. Trevor got on the board with a very, very nice mainframe, about 106-inch deer, just a nice 3x3. I was able to follow up 2 days later on a real tight frame buck. You know, I talked about if I was going to get a nice deer out of Mexico, I wanted something with some character. And with that buck having a big eye guards and a little bit of extras, a little bust off in line, fit the bill just right. Unfortunately, as you saw, we... took a shot about 500 yards across canyon. Things happened and ended up getting him just obviously right from the back side of the jaw out the top of the nose essentially. Luckily got back on pretty quick and made another shot and ordered him down quickly. But other than that, we made an attempt at a bigger buck that morning prior to shooting mine. Ended up just kind of getting into a situation where we couldn't quite get set up right. Fortunately enough, the next day, Hunter, as we were going up to get pictures of my buck, decided it'd be a good idea to go over where we had first seen that buck Hunter or Sue ended up killing. Luckily, Hunter's buck ended up being in that same pocket from the day before, and we were able to get set up. It was more of a run and gun situation. You know, we didn't have exactly the right amount of time, knowing that buck was on his toes a little bit more after the day prior. Luckily, we rushed downhill, got set up quickly. The guys were able to keep a good glass on him. Rudy was up top with Trevor as Hunter and Harney Garcia and myself rushed down to the bottom. Luckily enough, that buck ended up coming towards us out of that pocket, and Garcia made a phenomenal shot. Ended up getting him pretty much almost straight on, shot him essentially over the top end of the back, busting out through that offside shoulder, and I was able to get him down quickly. Fortunately enough, he went down in one shot and made for a quick pack out. As the guys joked, we ended up having a couple bucks on the Burro this trip, hint the name of this video, which ended up being kind of significant. You know, as nasty as that country is, you know, we could have definitely gone in there, and packed out the deer. Fortunate enough, we were able to, have the guys, Adam, Rudy, and everyone else just essentially go in there and make it a little bit more efficient for us. So, but overall, it was a phenomenal trip. I can't thank the guys enough at Sonora Outdoors for getting us down, especially on my first Coues Deer hunt ever. I'm definitely looking forward to doing it again. So hopefully we can get some more footage. Excited to be able to share this with you guys and hope to have some more success in the future and get some draw tags. So we'll see what 2024 holds and hope for the best.